It's back, bros. Bonjour guys, welcome back to the Road to Glory episode number 11. And today guys, we're gonna show you our first ever FUT Champions team on FIFA 19. Guys, just to let you know, this team is really, really good and we are super excited to kickstart FUT Champions with this squad. The budget is around 250,000 coins, but today we're gonna talk about all the players and our custom tactics that we will use throughout the first FUT Champions. So if you guys are hyped up for the return of FUT Champions, smash a like and definitely subscribe for more FIFA 19 squad builder and of course more FIFA 19 FUT Champions content. As I said, brothers, the aim of this series is to finish top 100 with a club we put zero money into the game. Yes. So if you guys want to follow our journey, we have made already 10 other episodes, so make sure you guys check them out. So right now we do like the 4-1-2-1-2-2 formation.
Yes guys, so originally at the start of the FIFA 19, we rocked with the formation 4-3-2-1 as usual. But then as soon as we started to get the feeling and the rhythm of the FIFA 19 gameplay, we were like, damn, in this FIFA 19 you need to have a two striker formation. And this is why we decided to rock for the first few champions with the 4-1-2-2 formation. So guys, in the goalkeeper position, we have an unshotable item.
Yes.
It is the best high rated player that we packed on this account on the Road to Glory, and it's Samir Handanović. There's not really much things to say about Samir Handanović, guys, because he's a goalkeeper in FIFA 19. Either it's gonna be amazing or either it's gonna be really broken, but in a bad way.
Yeah, exactly. Handanović, definitely one of the best workouts we have packed so far. With 28 games played, I do think it's one of the best keepers, though, in my opinion, that I've tried. I do think Areola is better, in my opinion, but nevertheless, the right back of our squad, we have invested into the inform of Thomas Meunier, because look at that card, brothers, almost greedy gang except for the dribbling, but we can really feel a lot of improvement compared to the normal Meunier. The 82 rated, I think.
Yes, the 82 rated, yeah. And with that card, bros, the 94 stamina is really coming clutch. I mean, you can really feel that in-game is going to push forward, and that's personally what I love for my fullbacks in FIFA 19, some really strong and a lot of stamina in my fullbacks. This is a key stat in my opinion, bros. Then the first center back, the biggest surprise was is as well an incredible item, just like Handanović, and it's Marquinhos. Bros, the pace, the defending is amazing, even though the strength for that Marquinhos, I gotta admit, It's not Bailly, boss, but really good surprise, Marquinhos.
Yes, you guys know him already. We have made a couple squad builders with Marquinhos. We really enjoyed the card. We decided for the first few champions to put him, I think, what is the chemistry star that increased?
It's Sentinel.
Sentinel that increased defense and physicality. As you can see, his strength goes up to 84, jumping 96, and aggression 90 in-game when you apply the chemistry style. I think this will help out Marquinhos a lot, especially for the first few champions.
Yes.
Now we do have Miranda with the anchor chemistry style. Guys, I'm not gonna lie, Miranda is such a great goalkeeper on FIFA. Defender, center back, my bad. Such a great center back on FIFA 19. He is just really, really good and he's fairly cheap at the moment. So if you're looking for a Serie A center back, if you don't have enough coins for Chiellini or Manolas, I will highly recommend you guys go for Miranda, because medium high work rate, 6'1", great pace, decent physicality, and his defending skills, his tackling, and his interception are just perfect for center back.
This is as well, aka one of my top 3 best surprise in FIFA 19. It's Alex Telles. Guys, his stamina, like I mentioned with Thomas Meunier, really important. That Alex Telles in the left back position does have 92 stamina. Will cost you less than 15,000 coins. I really consider him as the cheap Alexandro.
Oh yeah, for sure.
The way he moves forward, the way he's gonna cross the ball sometime to level to a striker, to Lewandowski, bros. He's really a fullback that I will definitely recommend you guys if you don't have enough coins for Alexandro.
But of course, bros, we're gonna improve slowly the squad with our FUT Champions rewards, with our division rival rewards, because we're grinding a lot on this account.
But one thing can be for sure, bros, we're gonna keep Alex Telles in the left back position for a while. The CDM of the team, 5'11", high high work rate, Paulinho. I cannot stress enough the fact of how good Paulinho is. You can play him in the camp in a center mid position, in a CDM position. That guy will always be present in the big games. And this is why we decided to put Paulinho in the center defensive mid position. Yes, he's a bit expensive, more than 15,000 coins. Should I say it's worth it? Big thumbs
definitely
up. Go for it.
You say he's expensive. I don't think he's really expensive. For our first few champions, you need some really good players. Paulinho, if he was playing in the Premier League, would have been more than 150,000 coins. Because he's in the Chinese League, he's only 15,000 coins, maybe more or less 20,000 coins, depending on PlayStation or Xbox. Honestly, for center defensive mid, we cannot do better for our budget. Axel, Witzel, and guys, for a box-to-box midfielder, we need a lot of stamina and a complete midfielder. Axel Witzel, with his height and with his statistics, with those ratings, he is just absolutely awesome. As a right center mid, he's 6'2", guys. That's super important. The height in the midfield is where you're going to win most of your game on FIFA 19 Ultimate Team. And then after, our left center mid will be Anderson Talisca. We used to have the in-form version of Anderson Talisca, and surprisingly, I do think the normal card is better than the in-form. I don't know, bros, it makes no sense, but I don't know, sometimes in-form works like that. We decided to put the marksman chemistry star that increases his dribbling, shooting, and physicality. And yeah, bros, now let's move on to the cam of the squad. It's gonna be Thomas Müller. Yes, guys, he's high-rated. He might not have the most sexiest card, but Thomas Müller will do the job for you, especially in the cam position. High work rate, gonna help out a lot Paulinho, Witzel, and Talisca for the defensive work. And then after, when he gets forward, his finishing is top-notch, his attacking position and his composures are absolutely lethal. Robert Lewandowski is just the complete striker in FIFA 19, and what I love about this card compared to the previous FIFA is that 4-star skill move. Bros, as soon as I saw that in FIFA 19, I was like, damn, that Lewandowski is a must-try for FIFA 19, and bros, I was right. For 121,000 coins, as you can see, in 75 games, he scored 55 goals, which is not the best ratio, I gotta admit, but we had so many DCs, and as well, just the fact that you need to get a bit used to with the formation. And Robert Lewandowski, for me, bros, is a 10 out of 10 striker, I would really recommend. And then, next to him, we have his ex-best friend, because when Lewandowski was playing with Marco Reus in Dortmund, they were the best friend. Now, I don't think Reus is friend anymore with Robert Lewandowski in real life, because Lewandowski decided to join München, Bayern München. Yes. Let us know, guys, in the comment section if this is true, because I used to watch some of them videos, you know, on Instagram where they show the football compilation and stuff.
The iFab as well.
And yeah, exactly, like Reus and Lewandowski used to have like a special handshake, but then now when they play against each other, when they see each other, they don't do it. So let us know in the comments, bros, if this is true or if this is only rumors. Normally he's a left mid, but we're gonna play him as a striker, bros, of course, for the first few champions. We have purchased him for 51,000 coins.
Yes.
With the hype of the Bundesliga Player of the Month, right now his price is rising up, and as well he's in the current Team of the Week. So if we can do a great few champions, what do I mean by this? If we can potentially finish Elite, Marco Reus in form gonna join the squad. Hopefully, bros, I reckon his price will be around 200,000 coins. That will be perfect
the
for the squad.
Marco Reus, you mean?
Yes.
In form Cam Marco Reus, I think that's gonna be the card, bros, that we're gonna try to pick after the first few champions, because that position change to the midfield, bros. I mean, for us, as you can see with the team, we need that striker Reus in the squad, even though Rana is playing on 7 cam, which is not a huge problem, I would like to say. This is the team, guys, most importantly. Now we're gonna move on into the custom tactics. For me, bros, the formation of FIFA 19, it's great, but it's what you do with it that's the most important, and the custom tactics is the best tool that you guys can utilize to win and to improve your win to losses ratio in FUT Champions.
So guys, right now we're just gonna show you the balanced custom tactics that we use. We're gonna do maybe, like, if you guys really want to, like a full detailed custom tactics video of what we use in FUT Champions. But first of all, I wanna play our first FUT Champions to see what is the team playing like and what custom tactics will work best for their formation and for us in the upcoming FUT Champs. We use price after possession loss. This is super important because we love to have the possession on FIFA. Like that, we can control our opponent, we can control the game.
Nevertheless, we decided to put with 5 and def four bros. We have made as well the full custom tactics detailed video for you guys. If you have any question, go watch that video. And then in the offensive part, we decided to put fast build up.
Yes, this is really important because with that formation, especially with Reus and Lewandowski on top and Miller as a cam, we do need to go forward really quickly. Yes. So as soon as we get the ball, we do have fast build up because we have pacey forwards. And so like that, they can make runs forward. That's going to be super important. Players in the box, we put 6 out of 10 because of the height of Talisca, Witsel, when the fullbacks cross the ball. Yeah. Like that, you can have some more players in the box. And as well, Lewandowski is tall, 6 foot tall, so he can definitely put some headers. And then corners, 4 out of 5 because corners are really overpowered. And free kicks, 3 out of 5.
We're not gonna use it directly, bros. Free kick is always called a second player during free kicks, so it doesn't really matter. The player instruction that we're currently using in FIFA 19, it's really simple, guys. We're gonna get in details. All the fullbacks and all the center backs will be stay back while attacking. Then for Paulinho, the center defensive mid, we decided to put stay back while attacking. Of course, we don't want Paulinho to be playing as a cam. No, we want him just in front of that defense. Kind of like N'Golo Kante or Sergio Busquets in real life, boys.
And because he is the only center defensive mid, we decided to put him defensive position, cover center. That is really important, bros, especially if you have only one CDM, then after, or 2 center mid, or left and or right center mid, stay back while attacking. Because of their
work rate,
they're going to still go forward. We want them as well to go forward, but first of all, we want them to do the defensive work. Therefore, we use stay back while attacking for both of them. As you can see right now, for Axel Witsel, balance crossed runs, stick to position, cover wing, and normal interception. Anderson Talisca will be a little bit different because as you can see, it's stay back while attacking and get into the box for crosses because of his height, he will put his header and can score a couple goals here and there because he is going to stay in the second post either when Witsel or Mooney crosses the ball. It's really important. Then after, for Thomas Müller, we want him to stay forward because he is our cam. Because he does have a lot of stamina,
yes,
we're going to use aggressive interception for his interception so like that he can press the opponent. Especially in future champions, we want to get the ball ASAP. We want to have the ball as much as we can, balance crossing runs and stick to position. I want to try maybe free roam on Thomas Müller, but first of all, I want to say stick to position because his attacking positioning is excellent.
He's amazing. His attacking positioning was absolutely insane. Thomas Müller is in every good opportunity to score for us. That's actually insane about him. Then for the 2 striker, we decided to put, first of all, Robert Lewandowski as the target man. He's the strongest between him and Reus. He does have 84 strength, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
And guys, stay forward as well for the defensive support. I don't want Lewandowski to have back the defense, bros. There's already the midfielders to do the job defensively. I want my striker to be able to score in FIFA 19. And then as well, Marco Reus getting behind because he's the fastest between Lewandowski and himself. So getting behind, that's for sure.
But bros, in case we do go maybe extra time, we will need some super sub. And this is what we use when we bring on super sub players. As you can see, Iago Aspas instead of Anderson Talisca, Romain Alessandrini instead of that Thomas Müller, and Lucas Piszczek instead of Axel Witsel.
Yes, this is the triangle, bros. I think it's really important in FIFA 19 if you bring on some players to put them in the midfield. You will feel like it's a new game whenever you bring super sub into the midfield, and especially that guy, Lucas Piszczek, bros. He is a tank. You put him on the field as a super sub. Make sure to purchase him. He is costing less than 2,000 coins, bros. He will definitely do the job for you. And finally, Alessandrini in a camp position, bros. What a wonderful player, I'm not gonna lie. 4-star with foot, 4-star skin move. In that camp position, in the central position, he's gonna assist to Lewandowski and Marco Reus really well, and as well, he can bang some long shot.
That was our first FUT Champions squad builder. Make sure you tune in into our live stream tomorrow, and of course, during the weekend for our first FUT Champions. We are super hyped. Hopefully, we're gonna get Elite, that's gonna be the aim. If we can get gold 2, gold 1, I'm not gonna lie, bros, that would be pretty cool. We're gonna do like a highlight video after the future, after the weekend league, basically, where we show you all games that we have played live. You guys know it by now with the Road to Glory. We're gonna show you every single game, what went wrong, what went really well,
and our thoughts as well, and how we can improve, and how we can potentially, bros, finish Elite. I'm not gonna lie, and like you said, the aim is gonna be Elite, bros. That's our first aim after. Will the gameplay will follow us with that? We shall see about that. But with that being said, if you guys have enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and to subscribe if this is the first time watching Liam and I on YouTube. Anyway, brothers, if you have any way that we can improve the squad, let us know down below in the comment section.
Please.
Smash a big like on the video to show the support. And guys, don't forget to subscribe for more FIFA 19 Road to Glory content. It's been your boy Liam.
My name is Vincent. Catch you guys tomorrow with a big day. Big day coming.
That's
big time.
Big day,
it's a big time.
Live stream, double upload maybe. Make sure you guys stay tuned.
You guys will love it. You guys will love it.
Exactly. Make sure you guys have the notifications on. Catch you guys tomorrow, bros.
Au revoir.